Welcome to our new biosolids handling process at the Clinton River Water Resource Recovery Facility in Oakland County. We're proud to be one of only three such facilities in the entire country and the first in Michigan to use a thermal hydrolysis process, or THP, to turn refuse into reuse. Our footprint here consists of four purpose-built unique structures. A septage receiving facility. This facility will process up to 54,000 gallons of septage each day that's been hauled to the plant from a variety of customers. A secondary digester gas membrane storage dome. This giant duosphere dome can hold up to 81,000 cubic feet of biogas, captured as a byproduct of the thermal hydrolysis process. Paired with the existing anaerobic digestion, which cuts our dependence on natural gas and improves our efficiency. A covered biosolids storage pad. This storage facility protects and houses the final Class A exceptional quality biosolid cake as it awaits its destination. And a new two-story, 15,800 square foot biosolids handling building that houses an impressive array of miles of pipes, processes, and precision-tuned instruments can process over 150,000 gallons of concentrated sludge each day and reduce disposal costs by 50%. So, from intake to screening, to the THP process and storage, we're changing the way we look at biosolid disposal and making the world around us cleaner and improving the quality of all life. At the onset of the process is the sludge blending and screening system. As the sludge makes its way onto our biosolids process, it's mixed, blended, and pumped through a pressurized screening process where any debris is caught, separated, and disposed of. Believe it or not, the sludge coming in is about 97% liquid, so it needs to be dried and separated. That's where our centrifuge comes in. In the first phase of the sludge dewatering process, centrifuges turn sludge into a usable paste-like substance that consists of 16% solids. By spinning at ultra-high speeds, the liquids are separated from the solids, so it's ready for the THP process. The reactors in the thermal hydrolysis pretreatment process are essentially gigantic pressure cookers. High pressure, time, and heat breaks down the biosludge and makes it more palatable for the bacteria we've been starving until this moment. They're going to help us process 37,000 gallons of dewatered sludge each day, containing 25 dry tons of solids. So, as the sludge cooks under pressure, it's being turned into Class A biosolid. Without these machines and the THP process, none of this would be possible. But it takes a lot of steam to turn sludge into something usable. Behind the scenes are the boilers. These high-pressure steam boilers are a trifecta of efficiency, power, and dependability, producing 8,300 pounds of steam every hour, reaching 160 pounds per square inch, and topping out at 240 degrees Fahrenheit is no easy task. But these boilers have one more trick up their sleeves. Remember that duosphere that holds all the biogas? Well, these boilers can run from that biogas. Using the energy from the THP process means a reduction in outside power sources and a reduction in the facility's carbon footprint. This biosolids handling facility runs like a well-oiled machine, and from their stations in the biosolids handling facility electrical room, our facility staff can monitor, diagnose, and triage any issue that may come up 24/7. With over 30 electrical panels and two power sources, the electrical room is a central point of control as the sludge makes its way from intake to output. As we near the end of our tour, the dewatered, heated, pressured, and now Class A biosolid needs one more round of drying to get it ready for storage. It's back to the centrifuge area, where the post-dewatering centrifuges are used to dry the biosolids into a loamy, dirt-like substance. The final stop for Class A biosolids is to travel along a series of conveyor belts where it lands in one of our four temporary holding bays in the covered biosolid storage pad until it's moved to the main 20,000 square foot storage area capable of holding 7,000 cubic yards of biosolids. This covered biosolid storage pad keeps the dewatered Class A exceptional quality biosolids dry and protected until it is loaded and taken away for its final application as a soil amendment or fertilizer. We're proud to be one of the first three such facilities in the entire country and first in Michigan. And even more proud of the fact that the new biosolids handling building at the Clinton River Water Resource Recovery Facility in Oakland County is turning refuse into reuse. Now that's purely resourceful.